Hello, YouTube, and I welcome all of you back to another Rage video, where tonight, ladies and gentlemen, if you're also, first of all, welcome to the vest, the denim vest, and there's going to be like some patches and that put on this in the next couple of weeks and stuff like that. Shit, I'm so excited, dude. I mean, here's just like a few I've got already in that. I've got Pantera, got AC/DC, and I have a David Bowie one. That's the Bowie one is gonna absolutely be put on there. Like maybe the shoulder or maybe something like outlooking, because I actually ordered two of these, and I'm gonna get the next one in like the mail probably either tomorrow, which coincidentally tomorrow being Friday the 13th. But and it seems fitting as well that we're continuing this journey of the 50th grand anniversary of Exile on Main Street, and I was also ironically that it's the 12th today, so the same very happy birthday to Exile on Main Street. And let's continue where we left off with Shake Your Hips, which I believe was also, it was first done by a man called Slim Harpo. He was like a blues harmonica singer, and the rest is history, as you're about to see. So, if you guys want to check out the original video for yourselves, links will all be in the description down below. Let's begin. Shake Your Hips in 3, 2, 1, and... Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was... well, it turns out the problems with my throat didn't quite go away just yet, but that was Shake Your Hips by the Rolling Stones. And you know what? Considering how fast-paced and really really jumping that Rocks Off and Rip This Joint gave us before. It feels kind of like really, it feels right that we go for something that's intentionally rather slow, but really is sort of this great reflection of this of Slim Harpo's talents. Because I wonder if they got I'm going to check if whether they actually got Slim to do the harmonica parts, or maybe they got somebody else. So I'm going to just it's actually Mick Jagger who actually does the harmonica parts, and good on Jagger for doing that, because that was fun. That I know it's a very strange thing to say, but you know what? Imagine, like, it's like late at night, and I'm trying to get like a picture of where I can imagine this sort of thing being played on a loop. Well, they probably played Slim Harpo, where the more I think about it, than the Rolling Stones. But this seems like quiet, like a very quiet, gentle night, like sitting out on the front porch and just taking it all in. That one thing that I absolutely love about this album, as you're going to see, is that there's a great sense of immersion, that there's a side to there's a side to all of this that we're not seeing. There's a side to the Rolling Stones that, or even just the way they present blues and certain types of jazz in America, that they expand upon it and they make it their own. But they don't exactly neglect the people that influence them, because there are several songs coming up on here that sort of blend all of these together with the Rolling Stones' style that people have been accustomed to for 10 years before this. But let me just say this, like, right now. Because the next song is very, very sort of similar to Shake Your Hips, there's a bit more of a pace to it with an incredible saxophone solo. But it has to be said, this just feels right. It's a real throwback to the sort of crazes and dances that went on. This is the equivalent of the song "Let Me Take a Selfie" back in 72. I do apologize. Good on them for doing that, though. So anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed this reaction video. Please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section down below. Let me know what you guys thought of Shake Your Hips for yourself. And I cannot wait to see all of you guys again in the next video. Take care, and bye-bye for now.